Good afternoon. I am Ashutosh Gupta. Subject code is CS-401, Introduction to Compiler. We have already studied in the first year that what is compiler, what is the means of compiler, what is the role of compiler, C compiler. Now, in this subject, we will study the complete detail about the compiler. See, introduction. First, what is the objective of this subject? This course discusses the principles and techniques involved in the designing of analysis and synthesis phase of the compilation. The whole process of compilation is divided into two parts. One is the analysis and next part is the synthesis. There are total 6 phases of the compiler. Each analysis, in this analysis phase, it covers the first 3 phases, and in the synthesis part, it covers all next 3 phases of the compiler. We will discuss in this subject, we will discuss about the whole process or whole 6 phases of the compiler. It also designed an implementation of lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer, semantic analyzer, code generation schemes, type checking, and the code optimization and runtime environment. In this whole course, we will discuss about these topics. Here in this subject, we have one lab, compiler design lab. In this lab, we will study about the 2 Unix tools. One is the Lex and another is the Yax. And we will examine the structure and capability of the programming language with an emphasis on the demand of the efficient implementation. So these are the objective of this subject. So what is the prerequisite of this subject? Before starting the course, what we expect that students have the experience with the C, C++, C# or Java programming language, and working on Unix environment is essential. Experience using program development tools, compiler, linker, debugger, and some prior exposure of basic automata theory will be very useful. In the last semester, we have studied about the CS 358, I think 358, theory of computation. Some experience with machine language programming will be extremely desirable. Next, text and reference books. This is the textbook, and these are the reference book for this subject. Here, the whole course is divided in these lecture plans. This is the introduction part. First part is the introduction part. In the introduction part, we will study about the introduction of compiler, interpreter, what are the phases, what are the tools, types of the compiler. Next is the lexical analysis. Next phase of the compiler is lexical. So this is the first phase of the compiler. That is the lexical analysis, syntax analysis, semantic analysis. So the whole course is divided in these lectures. So in these topics, we will discuss these subtopics. So this is the whole course outline. In this, today, we will discuss about these topics, compiler, interpreter, and their properties, what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages, different phases of the compiler construction tool, grouping of the phases of the compiler, types of the compiler, bootstrapping of the compiler, cousins of the compiler. So today we will discuss about these. So now see what is compiler. In the first year, introduction to the computer and programming, CS151, we have studied about the compiler. Okay, what is compiler? What compiler exactly do? So we know that compiler, interpreter, assembler, these are the language translator. So here compiler, what compiler? Compiler is a language translator which convert any high level language program into the machine level language. So here we have defined that a compiler is a program that translates a program in a source language into the equivalent target language. Equivalent program in the target language. Generally we use the source language as the high level language. And the target program is machine language or any intermediate code that our machine understands. Now we know that I already told that this compiler is divided into two parts. One is the analysis and another is the synthesis. In the analysis part we have these phases, and in the synthesis part we have another three phases. So in the first phase, what is the means of lexical analysis? We have the source program. The source program is broken into the tokens. So we have the source string, read the source string, and broken into the string of the strings, and or you can say tokens. Next is the syntax analysis. In the syntax analysis, we have the tokens. Arrange the token in the some hierarchical structure that is called syntax tree. Next, semantic analysis. In this step, the means of the source string is determined. So we have the source program, compiler, and we generate the target program. So in this analysis part, we have already discussed the analysis parts. In the synthesis part, the intermediate form of the source language is taken and converted into the equivalent target program. Now see the execution of a program. How a program is executed? See the steps. First is the skeleton source program. We have the source program. We know what is the means of preprocessor. We have already discussed in the first year. So what is the means of the preprocessor? We have the source program. Now we have the preprocessed source program. Next is the compiler. Preprocessor source program is the input of the compiler. It generates the target assembly code. We know that what is the role of assembler. Assembler means it convert any assembly language program into the machine language. So here this assembly language program is the input of the assembler. It convert into the relocatable machine code. And we know what is the role of loader, link editor. So it link with this library and it generates the executable machine code. So the means is we have the executable code, data, executable code, and we supply the data and it generates the output. Now see what is the property of the compiler. It means property of the compiler means what are the quality in a good compiler. The compiler itself must be bug free. generate correct machine code. Generated machine code must be fast. Compiler itself must run fast. Compiler must be portable. It must give good diagnostic and error message. Generated code must work well with the existing debugger. It must have consistent optimization. So these are the properties or qualities of a good compiler. Or we can say a compiler should contain these properties. Now see the processing with the process of compiling. These are the phases. These are the 7 phases. Machine dependent code optimization and machine dependent code optimization. Independent and machine dependent code optimization. So here the code optimizer phase is divided into parts, machine dependent or machine independent. So actually there are 6 phases: lexical analysis, syntax analysis, semantic analysis. These are the part of analysis. Intermediate code generation, code optimizer, code generator, these are the part of the synthesis. Simple table, error detection and handling. Now see what is the process of compiling. Characteristic, this is the input. In the lexical analyzer, we know that what is the means of this lexical analyzer? It converts any character string into the token string. So all the characters are divided into the tokens. So means total equal to count plus rate into 10. This is the character string. We know that how it breaks into the tokens. Total, this is the identifier. This is the identifier. Equal assignment. Count, again identifier. This plus operator. Rate, identifier. Multiply, operator. This 10, this is the constant. In this way, the complete string is broken into the form of tokens. Next is the syntax analyzer. What is the role of this syntax analyzer? These are the tokens. Arrange these tokens in the hierarchical structure, that is called syntax. Next is the semantic analyzer. Semantic analyzer means the role of the code is defined. Intermediate code generator, it generates the intermediate code. Code optimizer, this is the syntax tree. It generates the intermediate code. Then the code optimizer. What is the means of the code optimization? Optimize the code. So it optimizes the code. Again, it generates the intermediate code. Then finally we have the optimized code, so we can write the codes. So we generate the target machine code. So these are the all reach the edge of the compartment. Here we are using simple tables. All the tokens are stored in this simple tables. Error detection and handling. It means at any phases of the, if there is any error in any of the phase, then it is detected. These errors are detected and reported to the or handled by. So the phases of the compiler, these are the phases of the compiler. We have already discussed about this. Lexical analysis. Lexical analysis is also called scanner. So what is the means of this? Lexical analysis, what is the role of this? It reads the complete source code and convert into the tokens. Then syntax analysis is also called parser. So we have the tokens and arrange in a hierarchical structure. So finally we have the parse tree or the syntax tree. Semantic analysis. So we have the syntax tree, and in the semantic analysis, if we have any type conversion, then we use any type conversion. I will explain all these features with the example. Next, intermediate code generation. It generates the intermediate code. We know about the three address code. We discuss three address codes in the microprocessor. So here we will use the three address code in the intermediate code generations. Then the code optimizer. So we can improve the intermediate code. If we can optimize the code, then we should optimize. So it reduces the redundant code and improve the intermediate code. Removal and detection of dead codes. Calculation of constant in expression in the terms. Loop unrolling. Moving code outside the loop. So then finally it generates the machine code. It generates the sequence of machine. So that is the output of this compiler. So what is the role of symbol table? Symbol table, it stores the information or the attributes of each identifiers. It also stores information about the subroutines used in the program. Symbol table allows to find records for each identifier quickly and to store the retrieved data from the record efficiently. During compilation of lexical analyzer, detect the identifier and makes it entry in the symbol table. So this is the role of symbol table. Then what is the means? So what is the role of this error detection and handling? What is the means of this? In any of the phases, if in the compilation each phase detects error, the error must be reported to the error handler whose task is to handle the error, so that the compilation can proceed. So these are the role of each phase. Now see the example. Now I want to explain all these with this with an example. Now see the example. Now see the exam. Now see. Input processing in compiler. We have the input A equal to B plus C multiply C. We have this input string. Now see, what is the first phase? Lexical analysis. Lexical. Lexical analysis. What is the role of this lexical analysis? This is the character string. This is converted into the tokens. So what is the output of this? ID1 equal to ID2 plus ID3 multiplied by. We know that A, B, C, D are the identifier. So the lexical analyzer, it converts the character string into the tokens. So this is the token generation. Or you can say token string. These are the token string. Next phase is syntax. Syntax analysis. Syntax analyzer. It generates the syntax. So see. ID1 plus ID2 multiply ID3. This is the syntax. This is the syntax. Next. Semantic. Next is the semantic analysis. Here ID1 plus ID2 multiply ID3, then INT to flow. We know that here this is the constant, or you can say integer. So here convert this integer into the floats. So here this is the semantic. Now we will write the code. Intermediate code generation. Here, now we can convert the into the codes, this structure into the codes. T1 equal to INT to flow. T2 equal to ID3 multiplied by T1, T3 equal to ID2 plus T2, and this ID1 is equal to, so this is the intermediate flow. Now we can optimize the code. We can optimize the code. Now how can we optimize code? Optimize. Code optimize. How can we optimize these codes? How can we optimize this code? Here, see, we can place this 16 here T1. So here we can optimize in this way. T1 equal to ID3 into 16. And T2 equal to, T2 means ID1 equal to ID2 plus T2. This is the code optimizer. So this is the simple code. Now in the next phase is the code generation. Next is the code generation. This is the, we can say, optimized code. Next is the code generator. Now we can write the code. We have the least optimized code, so we can write the code, assembly code for this. Move f id3 comma R2 and UL F for this MULF this 60 is multiplied with the R2 and the result is stored in this R2. Next is again move F here for this ID2 comma R1, then add F this addition R2 comma R1 and then move F R1 comma ID. In this way we can write the codes. See here, this is the optimized code. Next is the code generator. Store this 16. First ID3 move to this ID3 move to R2. Then multiply with 16 and the result is stored in R2. For this move ID2 move to R1. Add with R2 with R1 and the result is in R1. And move the contents of R1 in the ID. So this is the final code. So this is the final machine code. So these are the phases of the compiler. In this way, we can process a string next. Next is compiler construction tools. So here in our lab, in the compiler, your compiler design lab, we will discuss about these two tools. One is the next, and next is the JAWS. Legs for the scanner, or you can say to generate the tokens, and the parser is produce the syntax analysis. So these are the two Unix tools we will discuss in the lab, and the syntax array translation engine, automatic code generator, data flow engines. So these are the compiler construction. Then what is the interpreter? Interpreter, compiler. Here also the compiler plays the same role. It converts any high level language program to the machine level language. But the difference is the compiler compiles the whole program, or it converts the whole program, but in the interpreter it converts line by line and executes also. So it contains these four phases. These three phases are the same as the compiler, and fourth is the direct execution. Advantage of interpreter: modification of user program can be made. This interpreter is generally used for the beginners in the school level. At school level, we know that you have heard about the GW basic or basic. So these are the interpreters for the beginners. Type of object and that knows the variable. Debugging of a program and find error is simplified. Interpreter language makes the machine independent. Disadvantage of the interpreter: execution of the program is slower as compared to the compiler. Memory consumption is more. Grouping of phases of the compiler. So here these phases are also divided in these two terms. One is the front end, another is the back end. The front end it consists those phases that are primarily dependent on the source program and independent on the target language. So here these three phases are dependent on the source language and independent on the target language. But here in the back end, it includes these two phases: code optimizer and code generator. These are dependent on the target language and independent on the source. Next is the types of the compiler. One is the incremental compiler. A compiler which performs the recompilation of only the modified source rather than compiling the whole program, whole source program. Basic features: it tracks the dependency between output and source program. It produces the same result as full recompile. It performs less tasks than the recompilation. The process of incremental compilation is effective for the maintenance. Then next compiler is the cross compiler. Cross compiler means a compiler which runs on one machine and produces the target code for another machine. And by using the cross compilation techniques, platform independency can be achieved. So here the structure of this: S means source language, or that is the application program. T means target language in which the machine code is generated. I means intermediate language. It means in which language the compiler is written. So this is the cross compiler. bootstrapping of the compiler. Bootstrapping is a process in which simple language is used to translate more complicated program, which in terms may handle far complicated programs. This complicated program can further handle even more complicated program and so on. So writing of any compiler for any high level language is a complicated task. So it takes time to write a compiler for Scratch. Hence, simple language is used to generate the machine code in some stage. Example. Suppose we want to write a cross compiler for the new language X. The implementation language of this compiler is Y, and the target code is being generated in language Z. That is, we create XYZ. If existing compiler Y run on one machine M and generate code for M, then it is denoted by YML. Now if we run this code, this compiler XYZ using the YMM, then we get a compiler XMZ. That means a compiler for source language X that generate a target code in the language Z and which run on machine M. See, this XYZ . What is the means of this? We want to run a cross compiler for new language X. The implementation language of this compiler is Y. It's a Y. And the target code is XY. This is Y. This is Z. The target code is being generated in Z. So it is XYZ. Next, now if the existing compiler Y, this is Y, run on the machine M and generate the code M. So YMM. So this is YMM. Next, now see what it generates. In this, we can generate this like this. M. This is X, Z. Here, this Y and this Y. It should be same. This M and this M, it should be. These two languages must be same. So, this is clear. X, Y, Z. Here, Y, M, M. This is Y, M, M. If we run this X, Y, Z on this machine, then it generates the compiler, it generates this language for, this is the source language X and this is the target language Z, and the machine is M. So this is the cross compiler. Cousins of the compilers. We know about the preprocessor, assembler, loader, and link editor. So we know what is the role of assembler. It converts assembly language program into the machine language. So we know about the preprocessor. We know hash include hdir.h. So what is the means of this hdir.h? This is the hdir.h is the header file that is included in the, and the user can make the user function defined in the header files. We have already discussed the preprocessor and the header files in the C language. Assembler, we know assembler is also called the translator, which translates any assembly language program into the machine language. So any questions or review questions and the reference.